Question 5, Principal Deputy Speaker.
An increase in national insurance numbers issued does not necessarily lead to an increase in the numbers not in employment, education or training. A report commissioned by the Department of Work and Pensions and authored by Portis, Lemos and Gilpin showed that there is no impact on the numbers not in employment, education or training related to the number of migrants registering for national insurance numbers in the UK. It should be noted that not all those issued with national insurance numbers outside the routine process where individuals are 16 years old may be working. It should also be noted that some of those issued with national insurance numbers, although not UK-born, will be UK citizens. Northern Ireland Social Security Agency and Department for Work and Pensions statistics show that there were between 8,000 and 11,000 national insurance numbers issued to non-UK nationals resident in Northern Ireland in each of the last 4 years. This is around half of the annual level for the period between 2005 and 2008. It would be unwise to assume a causal link between the claimant count and the national insurance number registrations. Migrants will leave at any one time, not all will have jobs, and some will be UK citizens, even if not UK-born. It's therefore important not to draw conclusions about whether non-UK-born national insurance number registrations increase or decrease the number of those not in employment, education or training.
Mr. McNary for supplementary.
Thank you, Principal Deputy Speaker. I thank the Minister for his answer. I asked the question to inform opinion makers. The Minister tell me what sort of grip, as opposed to speculation, does the Minister's own department have on the relationship between these high immigrant figures and the number of jobs available to local young people aged 16 to 24, 32,000 of whom are not in employment, education or training?
Well, I certainly hope that the member will inform the people of Northern Ireland as to what is really going on, rather than engaging in scaremongering and scapegoating of people coming into our society.
Order, order. Ask Mr. McNary to remain seated, not to be badgering from the back row.
I think most people in the society are sick, sore and tired of the demagoguery that comes from UKIP about scapegoating the other for the problems that lie within our society. Let me state the facts as they stand. We have situations where we have problems with unemployment. We have problems with low and no skills. These are deep structural problems that have existed in our society long before mass migration became an issue in terms of this society. The same applies in terms of what people perceive, problems in terms of admissions to schools and also problems with waiting lists. These are nothing to do with the fact that people are coming to work and live in Northern Ireland. They relate to problems around our budgets. They relate to structural issues within our society that we have not yet come to grips with. The fact remains that we have seen our unemployment, including long-term unemployment and economic inactivity, persist regardless of the ups and downs of the economic cycle and the numbers of people coming in to Northern Ireland. Those are the facts. The statistics are there, and I'm more than happy to give those to Mr. McNary, particularly if he is committing himself to actually informing people about the facts rather than perceptions and the fears that people wish to stoke up for potential political gain. Let's not scapegoat economic migrants. Let's welcome them into Northern Ireland and recognise that they are playing a major role in our society. And they are adding more to our society than they are taking out. And let me even just make one example about our National Health Service in Northern Ireland that would not exist and would not function if it wasn't
Ministers,
for people
Ministers
come
time
to Northern
is
Ireland
up.
From other parts of the world.
Minister's time is up. That ends the period for listed questions.